Hello friends, welcome to a new lecture today on vascular injuries of kidney. Vascular injury to kidney. So vascular injury to kidney can be microvascular or it can be macrovascular injury. Okay, it can be either microvascular injury or it can be either macrovascular injury. So if it's microvascular injury, the most common is atherosclerosis. Okay, atherosclerosis in smaller vessels. Okay, so this atherosclerosis can obstruct the blood vessel of the kidney, thus resulting in decreased excretion. So for treating this atherosclerosis, we give statins. Okay, that is microvascular injury. What is the macrovascular injury? It can be either fibromuscular dysplasia or it can be renal artery stenosis. Okay, it can be either fibromuscular dysplasia or renal artery stenosis. Fibromuscular dysplasia, here the patients in fibromuscular dysplasia, there is some abnormality which will cause some dysplastic changes in the kidney. So as a result, here the patient can have hypertension or he cannot have hypertension. Then in renal artery stenosis, here there is stenosis to the renal artery. If you see the renal artery which is entering the, if this is the kidney, the renal artery which is entering the kidney, this has been stenosed. And as a result, there is decreased glomerular filtration rate. Generally, here in all these cases, whenever the renal perfusion is decreased, this can lead to decreased GFR. This decreased GFR will activate the cells, JG apparatus, that is juxtaglomerular apparatus, to produce renin. This renin will convert angiotensinogen to angiotensin. Okay, so this angiotensin will be converted, angiotensin 1, in the presence of angiotensin converting enzyme, it gets converted to angiotensin 2. So this angiotensin 2 will activate adrenals, and these adrenals will produce aldosterone, and this aldosterone increases salt and water absorption. Okay, reabsorption, thus decreasing salt and water absorption. So because of these changes, there can be hypertrophy of the kidney, and these changes will occur in our body. So how are we going to treat it? The main, if it's renal artery stenosis, we will have to do revascularization. That is, the renal revascularization is the main treatment. If it is mild, then we can just treat the hypertension if it's mild. If it's severe, that is grade 3 to grade 5 chronic kidney injury, then we better prefer renal revascularization. So, this is about the renal artery stenosis. Now, if it's the other thing which can occur is atheroembolic renal disease, where atheroembolic renal disease, where the thrombi or embolism will come and it will block the artery, renal artery. So it can come and it can block the renal artery. So most commonly it can occur in diabetes mellitus or hypertension or ischemic heart disease. Okay, it can occur in any of those. And here the patient will have clinical systemic symptoms because of emboli. It can be fever, abdominal pain, weight loss can be there. And because there is no filtering of substances, there is decreased GFR. So this will become activated, and there is increased water and sodium retention as a result, which will in turn lead to hypertension. So hypertension can be there. So the main treatment is to revascularize the kidney and to remove the emboli. So these are the different thrombotic diseases which are seen in kidney. So thank you guys for watching my lecture. If you have any doubts, please comment it in the comment section. If you feel something is inadequate in this lecture, comment it in the comment section. Thank you for watching my lecture. Thank you.